Hello, this is Angela Anderson, and I have a really fun project for us today. I'm going to be showing you how to paint a grizzly bear. He's a little hipster. He's got some glasses, but you can leave those off if you don't want them. I'll show you step by step the whole way through how to do it and all the colors that you'll need, how to draw him and everything. So I've got my husband, Mark, here with me today.
Hey, everybody.
And he is going to be monitoring the chat for me. And if you have any questions, you can just type those out and he'll get them to me as soon as I have a spot where I can answer. So,
all right,
we'll get started. If you're new to my channel, you'll want to subscribe to be able to participate in the chat. We're so glad that you're with us today. And be sure after the show to go to my channel and check out my other videos. I have all kinds of videos for beginners, and I'm all about kind of helping first-time painters feel confident and be empowered to paint, take some of the mystery out of it, make it easy and fun for you to learn how to paint. So we will get started with our grizzly bear. I've gone ahead and sketched out. I've got a 16 by 12 inch canvas. You can use whatever size canvas you want. It actually would probably look good on a square canvas, I think. And I'm just doing his head today. And I've prepped the canvas with a coat of white paint, just plain old titanium white. But if you want to use a color, I think he'd look great with the color behind him. So feel free to personalize it however you want. This is your painting. I'm going to put on my red glasses so I can see what I'm doing here. And I've got a scribe all pen here. This is a water soluble pen, so, or pencil, so it will, you can erase it on your canvas here, and you can also, you could use chalk if you wanted to, or watercolor pencil or anything like that. It's similar to a watercolor pencil. So the first thing I did was kind of try to figure out where I wanted my bear head to fit on my canvas. And so I kind of just drew a big old circle for the whole entire head. And the top of the head is cut off a little bit, so it's got like a little bit of a dip at the top there. Hope you can see this. I kind of pre-sketched it so I wouldn't have to think too much while I was doing this. And then it kind of just rounds out. The grizzly bear's face is almost like a heart shape. How's our chat doing today, honey?
Oh, good. Everybody's just coming in and saying hi to each other
Very good. So, and you can make him a little bit more wide at the bottom if you want to. And then his kind of body is going to come off to the side like that. We're not going to really see any of his body, just a little bit of the hair. We'll just indicate a little bit. Then the muzzle, the eyes are kind of right above middle. So if you kind of find your middle mark on your head, you're going to do your two eyes. You can do a straight line down to help you kind of know where to put your nose and everything. But I just did, the bear eyes are pretty close together, the grizzly bear eyes. So I did two circles and kind of leave like so, like leave two eye widths between your eyes, if that makes sense. So you could draw two more circles here, the same size. And that's about the distance apart you want your bear, grizzly bear eyes to be. And then you can measure from the eyes and down, and that's about where the bottom of the nose is going to be, from the eyes to the head, top of the head, and the eyes to the bottom of the nose. So that'll be your mark for the bottom of the nose there. And it's just kind of like a V shape at the bottom. And it'll be about as wide as the eyes, or maybe a little bit less wide. Two lines up like that, and then a curved line at the top to finish off the nose. Then from the inside of the eyes, you're going to kind of curve in and back out about the same distance away from the eyes. So about the same width as the outside of the eyes there. That makes sense? There's a little line down from the nose. The nose has a split in the middle of it, and then two more lines on either side of that, and then like a triangle shape here, like that. They're kind of uneven, but I'll make them even when I paint them. Makes sense. And then the bottom of the mouth kind of curves down and then curves back up to this line here. So he looks like he's not too grumpy. And then the bottom of the bottom lip there is just kind of a curved line to finish it off. It's pretty flat though, so you don't, it's not too curved. Right, and then the eye is sort of almond-shaped a little bit. There's a lot of black around the outside of the eye, so there's not a lot of white showing in these bears. So I just kind of did this kind of curved line out, and we're going to fill in most of this with black along the sides here. Then at the top of the head, the ears kind of are diagonal from the nose eye. That'll be about the center of your ear there. And they're really just like a teddy bear ear. They're really kind of cute. They're just like a big old little loop like that on either side. Any questions yet, honey?
Somebody just asked if this was the bear from You Can Prevent Forest Fires Too. I don't think it's Smokey Bear.
No, I don't think it's Smokey, and I don't think it's the Revenant Bear either.
Well, that's good.
That was a mama bear. She was pretty mad. No, this guy's a little bit more urban than that, I think. He's kind of a, you know, with the glasses and everything. He probably has some skinny pants and plaid shirts, you know. Maybe a bow tie.
Is he hanging out at the coffee shop?
Yeah, he's hanging at the coffee shop.
Okay.
That's it. Okay. I don't know if I want him that quite that jolly. Well, when we get to paint in here, we'll fix it all. So that's about all the sketching we're going to do. We're just going to do some minimal. I want to talk about the way we're going to do our lines for the fur. The lines are all kind of coming from the eyes. So these ones on this side are going to kind of come this way. And then as you get around the sides of the eyes, they kind of do this starburst thing like that. And then the ones at the top sort of split right here. And these ones go straight up, and then these kind of curve around this way, and these kind of curve around this way, and then come down from this side. So when we're painting, that'll maybe help give you some direction. The ones at the bottom are kind of straight down. So just kind of a star pattern all kind of coming from this center. The muzzle, the hairs kind of come straight across like this, and then sort of down. So I'm not going to sketch it too much, but we will get to the fun part, which is the painting. This really didn't take me very long to do my example. I've got a pretty limited color palette. I added a couple of colors at the last minute just because I thought I might like to have a little bit more of an opaque color. So I've got titanium white, unbleached titanium. That's just like a titanium white plus a little bit of yellow ochre. Carbon black, any black that you have will be fine. Burnt umber, burnt sienna, and this is raw sienna. This is yellow oxide, and teal, and phthalo blue. Now, if you don't have teal, you can mix phthalo blue with some yellow to get a similar color, or mix it with some phthalo green and white, and phthalo blue will make a teal color. Any kind of teal will work. And I'm not even sure if I'm going to use this. I didn't use it in my example, but I kind of thought I'd like a little bit more of that color in there. It seems like a weird color, but he does have like some of these greens and blues in his fur in my example. So first thing I did is just take a large flat brush. I've got a 3/4 inch flat here, and I'm picking up my burnt umber, adding a little bit of water to it. It's looking a little thick. Not behaving very well. May need to get some new burnt umber here. It's kind of clumping up on me. Okay, I'm going to set my palette down. I'm going to try not to hold my palette today, but it's kind of a habit, so we'll see how it goes. And I'm just going to start filling in the outside with that directional brush stroke. So I'm kind of following the outside of my bare face and sort of just letting my brush plop down and pull out so I get this fuzzy edges on the outside of his head. Go over the top of your lines that you drew. I'm just going to do this all around his face here. I feel like I want him a little bit wider at the bottom, maybe. We'll see. Come right up to the nose. I'm not going over the nose. Just going right up against it. That muzzle, I should say. What is that part called? I guess that's all part of the nose, right?
Okay.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Don't know your bear anatomy.
I'm not a bear expert.
Okay, sorry. No. All right. So you see how I'm kind of letting the... let me zoom in a little bit so you can see what I'm doing there. I'm letting the brush strokes be thinner and thicker in some places. So I'm kind of loading my brush fairly thick with paint. And then as I pull, as the places where I press down will be a little bit lighter and the outside areas will be a little bit heavier with paint. And it gives you these natural like brush strokes or like fur, like things happening. So we'll just keep on going. We're kind of going around the eye like that. Across and around this side. Don't worry too much if you go over the eye. We're going to be getting to that in a second. Just keep on doing this pretty fast. It's pretty fun, actually. It's sort of, I don't know. This is not going to look like mine. Yours is going to look completely different because, as you can see, even my example is going to look like different from the one that I did previously. So, these are very impressionist, random brush strokes we're doing here, so no two are going to be quite alike. So just don't try to have any too preconceived notions about exactly how it is supposed to look, and don't get too caught up in one getting all of your, you know, brush strokes to be exactly perfect. This is all kind of just a fun and relaxed project. You want to kind of relax and just kind of go with it. Enjoy yourself. As long as you're getting your brush strokes in the general right direction, you should just be fine. So we're going down, straight down the middle, and then as we get to the sides here, we're gonna, and I'm doing these in like short, choppy brush strokes because I want them to have this kind of fuzzy texture. If I was just to fill it in flat with paint, you wouldn't have this all this interesting stuff going on. So, and a kind of an older brush that's a little bit less perfect will actually sort of help with this effect. So if you've got an old scruffy brush, you could even do this with a like a hog's hair brush or something like that would work fine too. How you doing, hon?
Doing good. Somebody suggested a snout.
Snout. There you go. That's it. Yeah. Thank you.
And we've already had the question, what color are your nails?
Oh, they are. I did a chocolate brown. I don't have the exact nail color. I changed my thing this morning here, my desktop print, and I got the old tape all over it. So I've got like gummy stuff stuck all over my nails. So they're not as shiny as they should be because they've got like tape glue stuck all over them. But yeah, I found like a shiny chocolate brown. So they're nice and yummy color. Perfect for a brown bear.
Yeah, I'm going to say all matchy matchy there.
I know, he's a matchy matchy. Very matchy matchy. You'll have some little white canvas showing through here and there. That's fine. Don't worry about that too much because we're going to be putting several more layers of paint on here. So we're just getting, this is our kind of main undercoat on here. Don't worry too much about that. doing a little bit shorter brush strokes at the top here, just kind of tapping lightly and pulling a little bit so that I'm getting a little bit more control up here at the top. And then we'll fill the rest of it in. Ooh, that was really thick. What happened there? If you get an area that's too thick, you can just go back over it like I did here. Your brush will kind of act like a sponge. So if you get it kind of clean of paint and then go back over your area, it'll sort of sop up the extra paint for you. And you just want to be sure to do it when the paint's still wet, because once it starts to dry, it'll start to get sticky. And then you'll lift the whole thing off, and you don't want that. Okay, so he's looking fierce. I like it. Let's do his ears. And the ears are just kind of up from the middle, sort of, and out. And here again, I'm just going to kind of press down and do some very small little tapping strokes to get the edges a little fluffy. Not worried too much about the shape right now. Well, just trying to get the outside shape, but I mean the inside is not going to look quite right, so don't worry about that. We'll add some more colors as we go. This is a good angle.
Yeah, it looks close good. Enough. Yeah, okay. It looks good on the stream there.
Good.
Yeah.
Remind me if I go off camera here, because I've not got the whole thing on there.
Steffi asks, how are you getting the two different tones of brown?
That is happening naturally because of the way I'm loading my brush and I'm pressing down on it. It's got this lighter color underneath. I'll do it on my canvas or my palette. Since it's got the white underneath, when I press down and pull, there'll be lighter areas and thicker areas of paint. The outside areas are going to be a little bit thicker, where that paint is coming off the sides of the brush, and the inside area is going to be lighter. So that's how you're getting kind of this natural light and dark, is because I'm kind of pressing down and pulling. If I kept going and did a second layer on here right now, it would get rid of all this light stuff and it would just become a big brown, solid brown. So I don't want to do too much to it while we're at this stage, because I want to leave all this kind of fuzziness happening. I think he's looking pretty good. I wonder if his ears need to be a little bit bigger, but I don't know. We'll see. All right, let's grab some black. And I've not cleaned off my brush, so I still have that brown in there. I'm going to grab some black and just fill in his eyes with the black. And I'm just tapping using the corner of my brush. Here, I'm not really worried. It's not going to look really good right now. It's just going to be kind of a big black blob. That's okay. Just kind of setting it down. You can use a smaller brush if you're having trouble controlling this one. Just trying to kind of get the basic shape of that almond eye. And you can pull a few little brush strokes off to the side if you want. There we go. Then we'll do the nose. Actually, let's do the inside of the ears a little bit. A little bit of the black just on the middle part of the ear. It's kind of hard to see, isn't it? It'll be a little bit easier. Good. It's not too bad? Okay.
Yeah, you can see the black.
Okay, I'm going to put a little bit of black under his chin too, just a little bit. That'll be one of my darkest areas. So I'm just doing a little tiny bit, still leaving a lot of that brown showing through. Oops, I'm off camera here. Sorry. Still leaving a lot of that black showing through, or brown showing through, but I don't know if you can even see it. He looks like he has demon eyes right now, so that's right. It's fine. Completely fine.
As long as they're not red.
Right, exactly. I'm going to switch over now to a quarter inch flat. You can use a bright or a regular flat. Either one will work fine. I'm going to zoom out. Ooh, we got 100 people. All right. Do a little dance. We'll do our bear dance.
We got 62 likes so far.
Awesome.
102 are watching.
That's awesome. Thank you guys for watching today. Thanks. It really means a lot to us that you stop by and take the time to watch us live. It makes us feel like we're doing this for somebody, you know, not by ourselves, talking to ourselves.
Exactly. Reaching across the world there. And
exactly.
Just pretty building cool. Friendships.
Yes, exactly. All right, let's do his muzzle here. I'm going to grab my raw sienna and just a tiny bit of the burnt umber. We're going to start with kind of a dark color and work to light. So I'm going to fill that in. And it kind of comes down, straight down from the nose, and then sort of angles out. He's got like a little mustache sort of thing going on. He's already half hipster because he's got the beard. I mean, he didn't even have to work for it. It's kind of a no-brainer. I was telling Mark I thought he could probably be a good hipster. He got some new glasses, and they're fairly hipsterish. They're almost exactly this shape here. They're not red, but they are pretty hipster.
Yeah, we didn't go that bold this time.
No. Got to get you some skinny jeans, honey.
Do I have to be skinny to put on the skinny jeans?
I think that's optional.
Okay.
Skinny jeans, get you some plaid, maybe an ironic band t-shirt of some sort.
Nice. I'll have to grow out my beard.
You already know a lot of obscure bands from me, from me dragging you along to concerts, so
yeah,
you're kind of halfway to hipster already, I think. But you might have to wear a scarf.
Ooh.
Every now and then. I don't know if that's a deal breaker.
That could be the deal breaker right there. Wearing the scarf. I have been known to wear a scarf when it's very, very cold outside, but not just for fashion.
Not for a fashion accessory?
No.
Okay.
No, sorry.
You are working for a French company, though. You know, you kind of, that would be totally fine.
Yes, yeah, and we do have a contingency of French people working at our facility, and yes, they do
wear scarves
for fashion.
Yeah.
Yes,
yes,
yep, that's for sure.
Yep, yeah. See, you'd fit right in. Don't knock it till you try it. All right, I'm going to fill in his nose with some of this burnt umber. If you noticed, hopefully you noticed how I was doing the brush strokes, but I was kind of doing them straight across in layers all the way across here. So we were talking about hipster stuff, hipster culture there, sorry. So I'm just filling in his nose kind of carefully here because the nose is going to be sort of important. I'm going around the nostrils. Those are going to be black. But, I mean, in general, I'm not being all that careful. If you look at my example, his nose edges are not super clean. They're kind of fuzzy. So the whole thing with the Impressionist art is to not get too fussy with it. So I might go back in here and just sort of tap along the edges to blur them a little bit so that they're not perfect. That makes sense. I really like Impressionist type painting for beginners because it kind of takes a little bit of the stress out of it. So you kind of can be a little bit freer, kind of learn how you like to use your brush, develop your own style. I'm going to go in with black now and just fill in my little triangle shape and kind of come down with the edge of the brush and fill in that little triangle of black in his nose. And do my split down the middle. And then kind of go ahead and darken up that mouth area as well. Okay, so he's already kind of taken shape, isn't he? Super fast. Well, now just a matter of adding a few little details to him to kind of brighten his, up his fur in places and give him a little bit more detail. Clean out my brush really well because I had that black in there. Do we have any questions, hon?
No questions.
Good. Good deal. All right, I'm going to mix up my burnt sienna and some phthalo blue. It'll make kind of a blue, gray, green color. I used this color last week for the Weeping Willow painting. So, and I had this color left over when I decided I had to use it. So I went ahead and used it on my bear. And I really liked how it looks. So I'm going to go ahead and use that. It's nice and dark. I might add just a teeny tiny bit of lighter color. See how pretty that is? Let me add some white to it. I added a little bit of unbleached titanium to it just to brighten it up a little bit. I don't want it too dark. And I'm just going to start to kind of lay in on top using the edge of my brush. So it's setting down on the corner edge, chiseled edge, and pulling down. I feel like you can't see it very well because it's so dark. I'm just going to go around my bear, leave lots of space in between. We don't want to fill it in completely. We're just adding a little bit of this blue-green color for a little bit of extra something. I like using these unexpected colors in my paintings. It gives your paintings a little bit more interesting feel than just doing, straight old browns, which you could totally do it in all browns if you wanted to. But really in nature, if you look closely at photographs and things, there are a lot of other colors going on besides, you know, the ones that you would normally associate with. So like a red apple will have, you know, greens and purples and other colors in it, not besides just red. There's all kinds of colors happening in nature. Okay, just kind of going around. I feel like this is all black. Is this showing up at all on the camera? Because I feel like it's really dark.
Yeah, no, it's showing looking up.
Yep. Okay, you can see what I'm doing here.
Yep.
Good.
Okay. We have two questions.
Okay.
One is easy. Which brush are you using now? Did you change?
Yes, I switched over to the quarter inch. This is the Robert Simmons titanium line brushes that I really like. It's a number two. They're a little bit firmer than the sapphire, which are the blue handled ones that I also like. Sapphire a little bit softer brush. So it's a thicker brush. You could use a hog's hair bristle brush even for this, you know, since we're doing kind of random scruffy brush strokes. It doesn't have to be a really nice brush, but the a little bit firmer brush will kind of give a little bit of snap to it and make it a little bit easier to get this fur in here.
Okay, and the second question was, do you have any tips for painting more realistic looking hair for bears?
Yeah,
or for animals?
Well, I mean, the thing with hair is that you really do want to start nice and dark and work to your lighter colors. A lot of times when people are doing fur, the things that they mess up on or, you know, have problems with is that they start out, you know, with a light background. And then there's no place to go when you put your lighter colors on top. There's no contrast, and then therefore there's not as much depth. What I like to do is put the dark colors on, you know, do your thinner lines and the lighter colors, several different lighter colors, and try to focus on, you know, working in some dark areas. But then if you, when you get all of your lighter colors on and you like the texture that you've created, you can adjust the values just by using washes instead of having to go back in with more dark paint and paint in more hairs. Don't do that. Don't worry about that. All you need to do once you get all the hairs in there is just to go back in with a wash of a darker color and put your shadows in, and you've still got that texture showing through of the lighter colors underneath. And so you don't have to like redo everything that you've just done, if that makes sense. That's how I like to work with it. So really when I'm doing the hairs, I'm not worrying too much about the values right at first. Now this one is done differently because I am kind of working my values in, since it's more impressionist. But if I were doing this guy in a more realistic style, I would use a smaller brush and, you know, get a little bit more detailed with the each individual hair, and pay more close attention to the layers of the hair, because on the grizzly bear there's a layer of hair that comes around, and then there's longer hairs that come around his eyes. There's shorter hairs up in here, you know, so you just kind of have to look at your picture, have a really, really good reference picture so you can see what direction your hair is going and the length of each hair. That makes sense. I don't know if I answered her question, but hopefully.
Yep, they said thanks.
Okay,
great.
Awesome.
Tips.
Awesome. I'm just going to go back in here some with this darker brown and fill in some of these white areas here. Okay, so I've got that blue color worked in there now. I don't know if you can see that very well. That's better, I think. You can kind of see a little bit of that blue. He's kind of all over with the blue. I'm going to clean out my brush again. Now I'm going to soften up these edges around the outside of the muzzle. I'm going to use that burnt sienna color and a little bit of yellow oxide and maybe a little tiny bit of the titanium white, or unbleached titanium, I mean. I'm making a soft reddish brown color. I'm just going to kind of go over this transition area with that. Kind of soften that up a little bit. Add another depth of color to our muzzle. Add some underneath the nose. Maybe put a little bit on the nose itself. Just kind of tapping, using very light brush strokes, small little brush strokes. Now we're getting into the more detail part of it. I'm going to kind of start using shorter and smaller brush strokes to sort of fill in our bear. Okay, so now let's go ahead and make a nice light yellow color, and we'll start highlighting his muzzle. So I've got the yellow oxide and some unbleached titanium. And I'm just going to kind of very lightly start laying in some highlight color, leaving a lot of that other color showing through still. And I'm kind of doing it in sort of two layers, one layer kind of close up, then another layer a little bit farther away. And once you get around the sides of the muzzle, you can kind of, or the nose there, you can kind of change the direction a little bit and start pulling straight down. I don't have very much paint on my brush here. I'm just going to start doing these layers of hairs. And I'm not really doing hairs like I was doing there. I'm just kind of tapping little, like, almost little squares of color all along that muzzle. It'll be brightest right in here, right by the nose. So I'll go back in and do a little bit more of that later. I'm just kind of trying to add a little bit. I think I'm going to add a little bit more of the darker color as I get toward the top here. Change the color a little bit so it's not quite so bright. Grabbing some Rossiana. And filling him in. Fun. Okay, so now I'm going to go back with this little bit darker one and sort of define the mouth a little bit on the outside. Maybe put a little bit down here. Make sure my edges are staying nice and kind of fuzzy. Along the edges here, I'm just going to kind of add a few little brush strokes kind of coming out so that I don't have like a solid muzzle. And he looking good? He's already kind of halfway done here. Let's grab a little bit more of our just straight titanium white. We'll put a little bit right up here next to his nose, at the top of his nose. Just give that a little bit of a highlight. If you get an area that's too bright, like I did there, you can just grab a little bit more of your darker color and just tap back over it. If you catch it while it's wet, you can just blend the two colors together a little bit. Do I need to get zoomed in a little bit more? Can you see okay?
I can see okay.
You can see it okay?
I'm not painting, so.
It's fine with you?
Yeah, it's good for me. I'm just perfect here.
All right, I'm going to grab a little bit of my blue. Let me add a little bit of blue to the bottom of the nose to give it a little bit of a shadow. Maybe add a little bit of the brown so it's not like straight blue. There we go. That bottom of the nose is going to have a little shadow. You can add a little bit of that to the mouth as well. And I'm just using the edge of my brush. If you kind of push your brush to a point, kind of a flat edge here, you can use it just like a liner brush and just draw right along that edge and create a line. So, I mean, but if you're more comfortable using a liner brush, you can just switch to a smaller brush to do your lines. However is best for you. Okay, so just adding a little bit of blue shadow to the bottom of the nostrils there. I don't know if you can see it, but kind of subtle. We'll grab a little bit of our highlight color, and I'm not cleaning out my brush, and I'm just going to add it right here where the nostril kind of sticks up right here. Just a little bit. See that? And then I'm going to use this along the top of the nose and do a streak of color right along the top of the nose. That may be too bright, so I'll probably knock that back down with a little bit of brown here, but let's let that dry and we'll come back to it. Let me zoom in a little bit. I'll do the eyes. Okay. Shake your camera. Sorry. The eyes are... We'll start out with a little bit of burnt umber and yellow oxide. And actually, let me go ahead and switch to a smaller brush. I think it'll be easier for people to control with a little bit smaller brush.
And what's that brush called?
This is the number 4 round. It's about a quarter inch round brush. The Robert Simmons brand. And I'm going to go ahead and put in the eyes. The eyes are really in the on the grizzly bear. They're very subtle, like they're very, very dark. So you don't have to go real obvious like you would on another animal. The eyes are very kind of shadowy and dark. And the irises, I think, are very brown. So they're not all that distinguishable from black. So you want to keep your color fairly light or fairly dark. And put it over the top there. There, that's better. That's a better angle. Okay. Let's see if I can hold it up there so you can see it better while I'm doing this. All right. Then I'm going to grab a little bit more of the yellow oxide with some unbleached titanium in it this time. And I haven't cleaned out my brush. So it's kind of this color that we were using on the muzzle. And I'm just going to highlight in very lightly, just kind of along the bottom of that eye, on the inside edge, just at the bottom. So I'm not going all the way to the bottom edge of it. I'm just kind of adding a little bit of a lighter color at the bottom where it might be a little bit more translucent, catching some light. Okay, I'm going to grab my black, put our black in, our little pupils. Try to make them the same size if you can. All right, then I'm going to use this black with a little bit of the unburnt umber and just kind of put some hair around the outside of the eyes here. Kind of tap in and blend out those eyes, get a little bit more black, and just kind of give them some, like, almost like eyelashes. It's sort of this almond shape that they've got going on, so it's nice and dark all the way around, and then it kind of blends out into the rest of the face. I'm just widening out those eyes a little bit. I'm going to use some of my teal color mixed with that black and brown that I have in there and just kind of put a little bit of a teal shadow right up underneath the eye. Like that. Okay, let's do the same thing on the other side. We'll use the black. Go around it. It's a little bit emo. Got some eye makeup on. Is that what you're laughing at?
No, they're just saying that, you know, he looks mean and scary. And
oh.
I just told everybody that being hipster is no laughing matter.
That's right. So,
I mean, you got to be serious about it.
Yeah, you got to act like nothing phases you.
Exactly.
That's the thing. You gotta pretend like you don't care about anything. Nothing, you know, nothing's all that cool. It's just your...
The whole attitude.
Yeah, it's the attitude thing, right?
That's right.
You got to have the attitude.
And so when you get down with the eyes there and zoom out, you've hit 102 likes.
Ooh.
And so...
Do another little dance?
Well, no. People are requesting Stickman to get glasses this week.
Oh, yes. Yeah, Stickman needs glasses. Okay, good idea. Okay, so I'm trying to make sure that the eyes are about the same size on either side, grabbing a little bit of that teal color, and we'll just add a little bit of the teal color underneath to give them a little shadow there. Yeah, that's a lot harder to see when I have it down flat. Okay, let me pull this in, see if that helps. No, it's got to be like at an angle. Yeah, it's got to be.
So the lights don't wash it out on you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Except for at this angle, I can't see it very well. It shows up better on the camera, yeah, but for me, it's all in shiny.
It looks great on the stream. That's all that matters.
Okay, I'm grabbing this lighter yellow color, the yellow and white mixture, and I still have some other stuff on my brush, so it's not going to be clean. And I'm just going to kind of put in a little highlight on the inside of the eye, on either side. A little bit over the top of the black, just slightly. Okay, and that's about all we're going to do for the eye. We might go back in and add a little bit more of the brighter color to it. I don't know. We'll see. But let's zoom out and see what he looks like. So he's already kind of got some personality. I think he just looks kind of somber. I don't think he looks like mean necessarily. He's just kind of serious. He's a thinking bear. He's very serious about things. Okay, I'm going to grab a little bit more of my burnt umber, and I'm just going to tap back over my highlight on the nose a little bit, tap it back, because I feel like it was too much. There we go. All right, that's better. Let's go back to our quarter inch. And now it's just a matter of kind of highlighting this brown fur here. We're going to grab the teal, and I'm going to break it up with a little bit of the burnt sienna so it's not so in-your-face teal. Got some water droplets on there. Make sure I clean off my brush. And going to mostly highlight just around the top of the eyes and around this area. This area around here is going to stay fairly dark along the outside edges, and this will just add a few little brush strokes of this teal sort of around his face. Start brightening it up. So it's kind of part teal and part burnt sienna. And sort of define his brow, sort of straight up in the middle of his eyes here. And here again, I'm using the edge of my brush, so my brush strokes are a little bit thinner than they were with my bigger brush that I was using for the first layer of paint. Stay away from this area right here, because you want this area, kind of this triangle under the eyes, to stay dark, and around the eyes to stay fairly dark. So I'm not going all the way into that black area that I've got. And that's a little bit really teal. Tone that down a little bit with this burnt sienna. These all kind of angling in toward the inside of the eye. So they all kind of coming out from there. And I'm doing kind of two layers again. There's a layer that kind of starts here and ends here. Then there's another layer that kind of starts in between and comes out to about here, if that makes sense. So they're not like one long line from the eye out. There's sort of two layers of hairs there, or fur, whatever they have. I don't know, bears or fur or hair. I would say fur probably. I'm adding a little bit more of the burnt sienna to the teal color for under the chin, because that'll be a little bit darker area. I'm not going to add too much of my highlights down here. he fun? He's so cute already. I love him. Even without the glasses. He's really fun to paint. So we're almost at an hour. Let's do some highlights in his ear here. Just going to highlight around, kind of leave that center part dark, and just fluff out his ears on the sides there with a little bit of this color. Okay, let's grab the Unbleached Titanium and a little bit of the yellow oxide. We'll add some of that color. Ooh, that's going to be our brightest highlight, so you kind of want to go sparingly with this. Use a light touch. My brush is fairly dry, so it's kind of catching on the texture of the canvas and giving it a kind of a fuzzy look to the paint, which I like. Add a little bit more of this light color for the top of the nose there. This is the Unbleached Titanium. I feel like I want to do just a tiny, tiny bit of white in the eye, so I'm going to grab just a teeny, teeny, tiny bit on the corner of my brush here and just do a little highlight in the eyes to really make them pop. I really didn't use my white a whole lot on this one. I kind of a little bit more of this color up here on the ears. Add a little bit of the highlight color so that, like, in front of the ears, kind of press those back. It'll make them look like they're a little bit farther back. Grab the burnt umber. And just soften up those edges. Go back over your highlight color a little bit.
So this is an older bear?
Why you say that?
Because it's blue hair. No?
Could be.
Could be.
Could be. Blue haired. Yeah, I'm totally going to be a grandma with blue hair. I'm going, I always wanted blue hair. My hair's too dark. So I don't want to bleach it blonde, but as soon as I go gray, we're getting blue hair.
Go blue, that'd be awesome.
Yeah, I know. It's going to be cool. I think I'm going to put a little bit more of this lighter color just at the top of the eye. Just a few like small brush strokes with that teal and burnt sienna mixture. In between the kind of that transition area, kind of soften that up. He's about done. I think we're good. We can add a few more layers if you want to, you know, do more with him, but I kind of like it. I think he's good. So let's go ahead and add his glasses. Zoom out just a little bit more so you can see the whole thing. Isn't he fun? I think he's showing up okay on the camera. There we go. That's better. Really see all the colors now. So I'm going to grab some chalk and... got caught there. All right. Let me add some chalk. Let's make sure that this is completely dry, because if you make any mistakes, you want to be able to erase them. And I'm going to make his eye, the top of the eyeglasses, come up just above like that. So I'm just going to draw a line across above each eye. And then just on the inside of each eye, I'm going to kind of come straight down with it. Trying to make sure that they're symmetrical. And you could always draw these out on paper first. Actually, I think they need to be a little bit closer together, so we can do this. Let's do the bridge first, and then we can know where to put the inside. So the bridge is just below where the glass is. And there, and straight down, and then curve, and then straight again. Curve, and then straight again. Just trying to make sure that this line and this line are at the same level. And you could use your ruler or whatever you wanted to if you wanted to get it perfect. I just eyeballed it. Now I think I'm going to go to about right here with it. Glasses. Is that about right? I think. Maybe. Maybe bring this side up a little bit. Looks good. Okay. There's little wings off to the side here. They come out a little bit more. We'll be able to tell when we put our red out on it whether we got it even. Put out a little bit of red. Add a little water to it. I've got cadmium red medium. You can make your glasses whatever color you want.
Yeah, we had some people suggesting blue.
Oh, blue would be pretty.
Yeah, so we'll wait to see everybody when they post their pictures on the Facebook page, all the different colors they use.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. Okay, so I'm just going to go over my chalk lines. You might have to do two coats because sometimes the chalk sort of interferes with the paint just a little bit. And straight down. And this is just a matter of kind of taking your time. You could even use pen with this. They have these... acrylic markers now that are really great. Liquitex has them, and Montana brand also makes them, and they're just basically watered down acrylic paints in a pen, so it makes it a little bit easier to do lining and things like this. So I say that is great if you want to make it. I'm all for making it easier while you're learning to paint. Trace it, whatever you need to do. I will have a traceable of this on my Facebook page. I'll also post it on my Instagram and Pinterest boards, and the links to those are down in the description. I've got a thankful art page where people can go and post their artwork that they've done of mine for my tutorials, and we have a really good time, and I do Monday art chats on there live, just talk about different things. Last week we talked about brushes. So, I don't know why I did that side first, so I put my hand in it when I get to do this side. I may just turn it around so I don't, because knowing me, I will put my hand in it. I think I will. He's going upside down. Let's turn it in like this. I found that if you're having trouble controlling your brush, if you hold it kind of like a pencil and do your brush strokes in the same direction that you would normally draw or write with, you have a little bit easier time of it. Your hand is naturally already have that muscle control in that direction, so it kind of recognizes that and sort of just a little bit easier. So as I go around, I'm just going to turn it, and it'll be a little bit smoother and easier for me. I rest my hand right on the canvas, but if you've got it on an easel, you can use your other hand to prop up your wrist. If you have a little support under your wrist, it's a little bit easier to control as well. Some artists use a stick that rests on the top of the easel, just whatever works for you. A little bit outside of, I didn't do the, I feel like his what are the arms of the glasses are probably just stuffed down in his fur there, so
okay, yeah, they're not visible. About that,
he's so fluffy, I think they're just kind of lost in the fur. I tried drawing it out, but it just looked kind of weird having the glasses kind of come up here, because really they're going to kind of need to go above the ears so they stay on.
Well, weren't there those old-timey glasses that just rested on the bridge of your nose, right, and didn't have any?
Yes, arms? So that's what he's got, I think. Or...
yeah, the natives in chat are getting restless.
Oh,
they're,
about...
Well, that, but they're also really suggesting a bow tie.
Okay. We can do a bow tie.
Oh, man. Giving in to the peer pressure.
Okay, we got Stickman here. He's a mess. We add something to him every time we do our thing. Last week we did Weeping Willow, so he got some Weeping Willows. Today he's getting some red glasses. Oh, my gosh. These are the worst glasses ever. Look at that. Nice.
Oh, what did you do?
Actually.
Wow, that's great. No, just leave it.
Okay, just leave it.
You got to do that.
I could have fixed it. No. But that's all right.
He looks like he's wearing a mask.
Oh, my goodness. Poor stick man. If you want to get real fancy, you can add a light wash of white in the corner of the glasses. I'm just going to pick up a little bit of white and titanium white and watered down, and I'll put a little highlight in, just a little comma stroke, about the same place on either glass, and maybe another one like at the top here on this side. There we go. Just make it look like it's a little shiny. And he needs a bow tie.
Yeah, but a lot of people have asked for bow. Well, even if it's just a top half, maybe,
and it doesn't have
the full. Yeah.
Something like that.
Oh man, now that's really hipster right there.
Okay, what color? We'll make it match his glasses. How's that? Or should we do it teal? Let's do it teal.
Do it teal, okay.
Yeah, we'll do it teal. So the middle part's going to be the part that sticks out. It'll be a little bit brighter. And then I'm going to do it kind of messy because I don't want it to look, I want it to match the look of the rest of the painting. So I'm going to scrub it in here, and I'm going to grab some of my Phthalo Blue. Maybe tone it down a little bit with a little bit of the burnt sienna, just so it's not like Circus Color Blue. Ginger Cook likes to call the... I love that explanation. It's so true. Your paint's straight out of the tube a lot of times. If they're not pre-mixed colors, or primaries especially, are very circus color. Okay, so I really wish I had a picture of a bow tie. You shouldn't, like, drop this on me. Making me.
It's the fans. You're just giving them what they want.
Okay. So I'm going to add a little bit of the shadow there in the middle. Maybe he's got a crease in it.
Maybe polka dots or something in there, they're saying, too.
All right. We'll add some polka dots, too. Actually, let's just go ahead and do the whole thing with this darker teal. I feel like it's too bright.
Okay. Red polka dots seems to be leading the
red polka dots. I like that idea. Okay.
Yeah.
See, if you show up for the live shows, you get to, you know,
influence the artist.
That's right. It's a lot more fun. More fun for me, for sure. It's not one to go on there. Here we go. This probably should have switched over to my other brush for this.
That's what I was going to say, but I didn't want to really step on your toes there.
Really?
Yeah, okay. That other brush.
You were thinking that the whole time?
Yeah, the other one.
That would have done better with the other brush.
Yeah, I don't know which one of those 200 brushes you have over there that other one would be, but yeah, the other one.
All right, I'm going to add a shadow to I've got the burnt sienna and Phthalo Blue mixture here. We'll add a little pucker in the tie right there, and maybe right there. Now the cloth is kind of folded in on itself. Maybe a little bit at the outside edge. You are having too much fun in chat today. You're just chatting. You're just typing and typing.
Well, you know, you've opened the floodgates because we have people suggesting maybe a pierced ear.
Does he need a nose ring?
Pierced nose ring.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm just letting everybody know that he has tattoos under his fur, so
you
can't really see him.
Is that a hipster thing? I don't know if that's a hipster thing.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't know. Maybe.
Maybe. It's kind of counterculture, you know. That's sort of the vibe, so it could be. It could have tattoos. All right. I'm adding a little bit of Unbleached Titanium here to do a little bit of a highlight color. Don't want it too bright, but I'm going to add a little bit of a highlight at the top of some areas. All right, that's good enough, I think. What do you think? I don't know. Without a picture, that's about as good as you're going to get. Let me put a little bit more shadow in the center part of that bow tie. That side's okay, I think that's good. So we'll grab some blue red. We'll do little red polka dots in the bow tie. There we go. I kept the polka dots kind of imperfect because they'll be folded and, you know, not look completely straight with the fabric. So kind of just kept them pretty random. Actually love the bow tie. It's really cute.
Yeah,
good idea.
And somebody said that the red polka dots tie everything together.
That's right, they do. They tie. Oh, they, oh. Oh, please.
I didn't come up with that. Somebody else did.
Mark is not allowed to use puns on my Instagram anymore.
I didn't say it.
I'm
Bonnie said it.
Oh, no, no, that's fine. Bonnie can say it all she wants. She.
Oh, okay. I see where this is going.
Mark has taken over my Instagram account for me, so I can, because I wasn't keeping up very well with it. So if, don't blame me if there's anything weird on there. I may or may not have had to go back and change the captions of a few things. I'm going to add a little tiny bit of highlight to his glasses since we're over our 1 hour time limit anyways. Might as well. This point, I was trying to get it under an hour. I thought maybe this one would do it, but just can't seem to do it. I've added a little bit of white to my, just add a little bit of shine to some areas on the glasses. Very, very subtle. Maybe a little bit on some of the bow tie polka dots. And I think we're good. Hope you've enjoyed this. It has been a lot of fun for me. And I think we're going to do a fox friend of his. So I'm not sure. Next week's going to be a shorter video. So we maybe can do him next week, the fox friend version, because I think it'll be about an hour, about the same amount of time as this guy. So I kind of already drew him out. A little bit. I didn't get to add anything to him, but he'll have some glasses or maybe a monocle or something fun. So, anyhow, thank you guys so much. It's been super fun for me. I really appreciate you stopping by, and be sure to check out my other videos after this. I've got playlists in my iCards. And I will see you. Oh, and thank you, whoever donated money last week. That was so sweet. Somebody donated a really generous amount of money. So we really, really, really appreciate that. It doesn't tell us who you are, so I can't thank you in person, but I just wanted to say thank you so much. So appreciated. And we will see you next time. Thanks.